Thanks for taking the time to view the introduction video of St. Mary's audiovisual system. St. Mary's has just completed an audiovisual upgrade in order to increase the intelligibility within the sanctuary and enhance the attendees' overall experience through a dual HD video projection system. The audiovisual system consists of a new AV rack in the sacristy. This rack includes touch panel control, house capacity settings, wireless microphone receivers, and audio processing. The house capacity setting switch allows you to adjust the speakers to the number of attendees within the sanctuary. The touch panel allows the user to adjust volume and mute various microphone inputs throughout the system. The new rack in the AV closet contains the Denon media player, computer interfacing, and a small touch panel for control of orchestra and choir microphone inputs, as well as playback volume. The system has also been programmed for the use of remote iPad control. We'll go over this in more detail later in the video. The new speakers throughout the facility include Rankus Heinz iconic steerable line array loudspeakers, a subwoofer for playback enhancement, and Bose 402 loudspeakers for balcony fill. There are speakers in the vestibule, as well as the crying room, both with local independent volume control. The house capacity setting switch is labeled from 15% to 100%. This corresponds with the number of attendees in the room. To select your setting, simply turn the dial to your desired percentage, then press and hold the button for half a second. This will then focus the loudspeakers to the desired listening area. Using the system at 100% is strongly recommended. The system then could be adjusted or changed for a smaller, more private program. To use the wireless microphone with the system, simply insert the battery into the bottom compartment of the belt pack. Then close it, make sure it is locked, and turn the belt pack on. You are now ready to use the wireless microphone with the audiovisual system. The touch panel, which is located in the sacristy rack, allows you to adjust volume on the wireless microphones as well as the wired microphones. Each control contains a mute switch and a fader to adjust the levels of each microphone. There are also meters on the right-hand side of the screen. These indicate the level of output in the sound system. The touch panel also includes control of the ambo microphone as well as an auxiliary input. The auxiliary input is located to the left of the altar in case another microphone is ever needed in that area. To begin using the audiovisual system with playback control, including the Denon media player, locate the main power switch in the closet AV rack and switch it to the on position. There are many microphone inputs located near the choir and orchestra area. These inputs are located in the floor pockets. In order to use microphones with the system, simply plug your microphone in, place it in the stand, and you're ready to go. Now let's talk about control of the microphone inputs. In the AV closet, there is a small touch panel which contains all your volume controls of your floor pocket inputs. This touch panel also contains volume control, mute control, as well as playback level and mute control of the system. In order to use an iPad for control of the system, you will need to be connected to the hidden control network labeled iPad Control. The SSID and password are located on the wall to the left of the AV closet rack. You will also need to download the app called QSIS Control by QSC Audio Products. This is located in the App Store. Once you have downloaded the app, you need to confirm that you are on the iPad Control network by by selecting your Wi-Fi settings and confirming that you are on the network with iPad Control. Now that you are on the network, open your QSIS application. You will notice a pop-up list that contains all of the user control interfaces. By selecting iPad Control on the list of user interfaces, you now can have control of every microphone input and playback control within the system. Here are a few examples of control pages. There is a page that consists of the same AV closet controls that you have on the small touch panel. There is also a page that contains all of the existing microphones in the system, and a page that has all of the floor pocket mics so that you can control your entire orchestra and choir on one page. To use the Denon Media Player, simply insert your iPod or iPhone in the dock and you're ready to go. If you have a CD, you could simply open the CD drawer, drop in your CD, and hit play. Be sure that your source selection switch is switched to the proper input. If you have a device for playback that has a mini jack or a headphone jack, simply insert the cable into the Denon Media Player and insert it into your device. Select aux in and you're ready to go. Volume control for the Denon Media Player is labeled under Playback CD Player. Now let's go over how to use the projection system. Locate the screen and projector switches inside the AV closet. To bring the screens to their down position, simply hit down on the buttons on the left screen as well as the right screen. Then continue by pressing the on button on the left projector and the right projector. These are independent in case only one screen is needed. It will take a few minutes for the screens to come down to their operating position and for the projector to warm up. There are three different options for displaying content onto the screens. There is Apple TV, a VGA computer input, as well as an HDMI input. These inputs can accept either HD or standard definition video signals. Let's begin with the hardwired options. To use HDMI, simply plug in the HDMI cable to your device, then plug the other end into the rack input and select HDMI. To use HDMI with an Apple MacBook Pro or MacBook Air, you'll need an HDMI to Thunderbolt adapter. To use HDMI with an iPad or an iPhone, you'll need a Lightning to HDMI adapter. We strongly suggest using Apple certified adapters, as these are proven and tested to work with Apple products. To use analog VGA, simply plug the VGA cable into your laptop as well as the audio. Then plug the VGA cable and the audio connector into the rack and select VGA on the switcher. Both the HDMI and the VGA cables have been extended so that the user can use the cables in their desired locations. Now let's talk about connecting to the system through Apple TV. To connect your device to the Apple TV, you must be connected to the hidden network named Music. The SSID and password are located on the wall to the left of the AV rack in the closet. To join the Apple TV network on your MacBook Pro or MacBook Air, go into your network settings and change your network Wi-Fi settings, network name to Music, the password, and the password security. When you are connected to the Apple TV labeled Music, simply select Apple TV on the switcher. On the iPad, under AirPlay, select Music as your AirPlay device. On the MacBook, up on the top right under your AirPlay settings, you would select Music as your AirPlay device. This is where you would also turn on AirPlay mirroring so that you could display the desktop of your screen onto the Apple TV. Once you have all of these settings in place and you are connected to the Apple TV, you can now mirror your iPad or your desktop of your MacBook screen. You can go into your video section, call up the video you'd like to play, and hit play on your screen. You should then see the video play. When you are done using the video system, you can now hit the up button on the left screen and the right screen controls. Then reach over and press the off button on the left and right projector for approximately 2 seconds. At this time, the screens will retract and the projectors will go into their cooldown mode and eventually turn off. When you are finished using the playback devices, simply reach into the closet and turn off the main power switch on the AV rack. Please note, when this switch is turned off, the microphones in the room are still active. This only disables and turns off the playback system. This concludes the overview of St. Mary's audiovisual system. For technical support, contact Riverview Systems Group 408-347-3700 or email us at info@riverview.com.